New details now on this weekend's deadly crash. Cranston police say this SUV was trying to escape Warwick police when it slammed into a bridge and then burst into flames, killing the passenger and critically injuring the driver. Tonight we're hearing from investigators in Warwick for the very first time. Eyewitness News reporter Stephen Schuler joins us now live outside police station with the West Bay Mobile Newsroom.
Warwick's police chief tells us he fully supports the pursuit, saying the driver posed a serious public safety risk. Tonight we're learning more about that officer's response and his heroic actions seconds after the crash. A smoldering mess of metal burns along Route 2 in Cranston early Sunday morning. We learned two people were trapped inside this SUV when it burst into flames following a dangerous police chase through Warwick.
I think it was clear that they had no choice but to try to stop this vehicle. And it's just unfortunate it had such a tragic conclusion.
Investigators tell us 34-year-old Brandon Borge of Somerset was swerving erratically at speeds of more than 90 miles per hour when police began their pursuit suspecting a drunk or impaired driver. An officer followed him onto Tollgate Road with his lights and sirens on when he says Borge did a 180-degree turn and took off again down Route 2. As the car passed the Cranston line, police tell us it crashed, killing Borge's passenger and girlfriend, 34-year-old Barbara Ellis of Attleboro.
They try to go around the other side. They try to get close to it, but it's so hot.
Police are still trying to figure out why Borge fled. However, investigators say he was driving on a suspended license and has a warrant out of Florida for violating probation on two previous DUI incidents.
I am of the conclusion that these guys did their job. They did their job the way they were supposed to do it. And once again, they probably deserve medals.
Borge lost his legs in the crash, and right now investigators are using forensic testing to figure out whether he was under the influence of drugs or alcohol. That first officer on scene smashed the driver's side window to save Borge, and he's now recovering from cuts and smoke inhalation. Live in Warwick with the West Bay Mobile Newsroom, I'm Stephen Schuler, Eyewitness News.